here's what's happening. I'm going to sum it up, if I can. On Tuesday, so today is Friday, March 24th. On Tuesday, this past Tuesday, the bees swarmed up into this pepper tree, came back to the hive. I think it's because it was a windy day and it was too windy for them to be out here. Wednesday, it rained. Nothing happened. Yesterday, Thursday, it was sunny and beautiful, and the bees swarmed again. I have video of that, which I will show. So the bees swarmed again to the exact same place in the pepper tree that they swarmed before. That was at 11:30 yesterday morning. It is now 2 o'clock Friday afternoon. Hang on, I've got lots of neighbors leaving in their car. Kind of loud. So it's 2 o'clock on Friday. The bees have been there for more than 24 hours. They stayed out in the tree overnight while it was under 50 degrees, and it's been raining all today. So they've been out there this whole time and they have not budged. Meanwhile, back at the hive. Back at the hive, there's another cluster of bees at the entrance, and that's weird. I also found some wax moth larvae, and that's weird. So we just went in the hive, I cleaned that out. Inside the hive, there's plenty of room, there's plenty of honey, there's plenty of brood, there's plenty of bees. Everything looks good in there, except for the fact that the bees are clustering at the entrance of the hive and not doing any work. Kind of strange. Meanwhile, the swarm is still right up above my head. So, here's what we're gonna do. I have to go get the kids from school, but Tom and my dad are going to place up on the roof, I'll show you in a minute, they're gonna place one of Dad's supers from his hive that's empty right now with a little bit of old comb in it, and they're gonna put it up on the roof and see if maybe they can lure the swarm into it. We're not sure if the queen's in that swarm. Why has the swarm been there so long? Why haven't they moved on or moved back like they did Tuesday? I mean, it's all very weird. And my dad, who's been beekeeping for a lot of his life, doesn't have any idea what it is. And most of the people I talk to don't really understand it either. So who knows? If we can collect the swarm and Dad can take them home, if there's a queen, then hopefully they'll survive. They're not gonna survive much longer up in this tree. It's raining and it's cold. So that's what's going to happen. I hope Tom can video some of it and we can get all of this. Maybe we can get this entire story in one big video. That would be exciting. So that's what we're trying to do. I'm not sure if it'll work, but I'm hopeful that all the bees are going to be okay. All right.
I like to figure out where they're going. I don't know if you can see them. Well, through the sky. Looks like they might be heading for the magnolia tree.
hope they don't go too high. I hope they go somewhere I can get them. Guys, going. I think they're. To me, it looks like they're looking awfully interested. I don't even know if you guys can see this. Can you see them up here? It's like they're interested in the magnolia tree. As their intermediate spot before finding a new home, or at least, wow, can you see all those bees up there? Can you see it? They're gonna go in the magnolia. Well, that's a lot sturdier than the pepper tree. They're not very inventive. I wish they would come down closer to the ground. All right, so it looks like most of the bees have left that are gonna leave. I wonder if the queen's up there yet or if they're trying to gather her. Still a lot of bees flying around here. Hey, I'm having a bee swarm over here, just so you know. They're not very aggressive when they're swarming because they've just eaten a bunch of honey. They're just looking for a new place to live. My neighbors are pretty unconcerned, which I guess is nice. But it would be nice to share this with somebody. I wish somebody would come watch with me. Okay, so the hive seems calm, and the main activity seems... it's up here in the trees. Oh no, they're going back to the pepper tree. Dang it! Are they really? You guys are stupid. It's too high. I can't do anything about you if you're up there. Yeah, look at that. They're gonna go right back to the same place they tried before. Crapola. Well, at least it's not windy for them. That's good. But there's no way we're getting all the way up there with the ladder. That was really fast. They all made it up here. Really fast. Now let's see if the queen makes it up. Huh, no blue jays this time, eating bees right and left. There they are congregating. I don't know if I can get that for you. They're like, right, they're congregating right in there, right behind that. You can see
in this, let me see if I can, where's my finger? There it is. So, right up there, you see them congregating? Rats. It's way too high for us to get up there. Well now, let's see what happens. Let's see if they come back home. Or if they try again. Or if they leave. Alright, I'm gonna pause. Well, it's much calmer now. There's only a few bees flying around, and most of them are in this cluster. Now, I suppose one of two things is gonna happen. I used to think just one thing would happen, but now I guess there's one of two things. So, either they'll send some scouts out to find a new house, and then when the scouts find it, they'll come back and show everybody where to go. Or, and there, so hard to show you right above my fingers where they are, but in the pepper tree, not the magnolia. Or they'll come back to the hive, I guess. I can't imagine they're gonna do that twice. So let's see what happens. This is from the backyard looking over the roof, and it's kind of between those two roof thingies. Let me get on a stool and see if I can get it better. Okay, now I'm up on a ladder. So now the bees are right above my finger there, that dark spot. Still staying put.
Just a quick update on our situation. We've got a super up on the roof now. Let's see if I can. It's a little easier to see. There we go. And Elizabeth's dad's up there. He's on the rope. We're going to try to maybe shake the tree a little bit and shake these bees. All right, here's a bee checking things out here. I put a little bit of whoop. We got hummingbirds around here too. And I put a little honey right at the entrance here. I don't know why. It just seemed like a good idea.
Oh, man.
That was another big bird that just flew by us here. So this bee's kind of checking the situation out here. Oh, he just fell. It's a little rainy still. I'm a little worried about this whole situation here. We shook the tree some, and until the bees started getting really angry about that, and then we stopped shaking the tree. So we'll see.
While we were waiting to see what the bees do, I thought I would just check in with you and see if you know how a swarm works. Because it's very interesting. I've talked to many of my neighbors during this process now, and none of them has really understood the whole process of swarming. So at some point, nobody really knows why, the bees decide it's time for a new queen. And the way they make a queen is that they feed a larva, any larva, doesn't matter which larva, a special diet of royal jelly, and that makes that larva develop into a queen. So once they've done that, the old queen has to go. Now, she could stay, and they could battle it out. That's what happens when two queens get born at the same time. They battle it out, and whoever wins, they get the hive. Generally, the old queen leaves with half of the bees, an entourage, and they swarm. Now, right before they leave, they eat a whole bunch of honey for the journey because they know they're not going to eat for a while. And they're extremely gentle, not aggressive at all. They have nothing to protect, no hive. I mean, they have the queen to protect, but that's about it. And so when bees are swarming, they're about the most gentle they'll ever be. I once heard somebody say, and I can't remember who, I think I wrote about it once before, I heard a man say that swarming bees were an act of nature, and if we were lucky enough to see one in our lifetime, we should stop and watch and really take the time to look at them. So that's why I put that whole video here on YouTube, because I wanted you to see, in case you'll never get to see one in the wild. So we're still gonna wait. It's going on 6 o'clock now. The light is dimming, and I feel like a mom worried about her babies. And so I'm out here checking every 5 minutes to see if they've gone into the box. Tom and I have a bet. I think they're gonna go in. He thinks they're not. So we'll see who wins. Meanwhile, it may not happen till tomorrow. I think it's supposed to be sunny tomorrow, so maybe they'll take off. I don't know. We'll keep you posted.
9 o'clock, Saturday morning. The bees are still up there.
Time for a quick mid-afternoon Saturday update. I've been gone all day. I just got back. It's about 2:30 in the afternoon. And the bees really seem to have found this hive that we have up here. This super. They're flying all around it. They're going in and out. So this might actually work. There's still a big swarm up in the tree. And there's a lot of activity in the hive, but it's a nice sunny day today right now. And these bees are, I'm not close enough to tell whether they're going in or out or what, but they are definitely, definitely interested. It's about 5 o'clock in the afternoon now. Here's the latest update on the entrance of our hive. Still a nice, healthy amount of activity, but not the big clusters that we've seen before. Bees are coming in and leaving, and I've seen some of them with pollen on. So let's take a look at what else is going on. Well, I'm up here at the entrance to the super, and I gotta tell you, I don't see much activity at all. So I think our swarm may have gone to somewhere else. Very interesting. It is Sunday morning, 11 o'clock in the morning, and there are no bees in sight. So I am 99% sure that this is not a box full of bees. And we're going to take this off the roof. There's 1% chance that I'm horribly wrong, in which case this is going to be a really, really bad mistake. Okay, here goes nothing. Well, I survived taking the super off the roof. There were no bees inside, so our bee swarm has departed for parts unknown. The bees at the entrance of our hive here are acting pretty normal, although they are not enjoying the fact that I'm hanging too close to the front of the hive. So that about wraps it up then. This has been a really interesting experience, and I hope you enjoyed seeing it with us. All right, see you next time.